party, the People's Democratic Party, which is led by Tendai Biti, who was the Minister of Finance during the inclusive government and was voted the best Minister of Finance in Africa. We do believe that the people are fed up with the non-performance of SANU-PF. You can see the current surveys where the issues of performance, when people were asked about jobs, service delivery, corruption, they were high percentages of people were dissatisfied with the performance of the current government. And therefore, there is room and scope for us as an opposition to be able to make serious inroads to what were perceived as ZANU-PF strongholds in the past.
Looking at what happens when you still in the MDC, the looking in Chitungwiza, what happened in Chitungwiza? MDC donated 11 wards to ZANU-PF by shooting double candidates. What are you doing to correct that as a fact? Not to repeat that mistake.
Yes, I mean, the opposition is talking about a grand coalition. You remember when we started off as MDC Renewal, now we are People's Democratic Party, we started and put the idea of a grand coalition into the psyche of the Zimbabwean people. We spoke about the grand coalition way back in 2014. And what it simply means is that as the opposition, we must field a single candidate at ward level, at constituency level. The most popular among us should be able to be fielded as a candidate. And more importantly, we should be able to field one presidential candidate. Now that presidential candidate comes from, if not all of the opposition, but most of the opposition. And that will deal with the issue of double candidates. And that will also deal with the issue of maximizing the vote for the opposition candidate for the president.
So can you say NERA is joining? Is PDP joining NERA? Is it?
We are working with NERA. Currently, our president, Tendai Biti, is heading a legal committee, chairing a legal committee under NERA. So we are working with NERA, and as such, we are working under code. We are working with NERA. We are participating in all the activities in Chitungwiza. Our president spoke at the launch of the activities in Chitungwiza. We believe that we need to work with opposition wherever, whenever opposition are working to unseat ZANU-PF. We should now move away from the icing of the cake to making the cake itself. And the cake is the grand coalition and working together through an electoral alliance or an activity alliance which maximizes whatever efforts we are putting on the ground to advance the cause for democracy.
Let's say, for instance, that the opposition parties, you win the elections as a coalition.
When we win?
Yes.
Yes, when we win, we've worked in a coalition government, remember, this is not the first thing. We worked in a coalition government, in the inclusive government. And if you look at the performance of a single party government right now, it is far much worse than what was prevailing during the inclusive government. The inclusive government, the economy statistics were up, investment was flocking into the country, cash was awash in the country, and people had an upbeat. People are divorcing, funerals have increased, our leaders are competing to die in different countries, in South Africa, in India, and so forth. It's now a badge of honor for someone to die in a different country than to die in Zimbabwe, and so forth and so forth. It is now a nation of death and dying after the inclusive government. So we do believe that once we get back to a coalition government, we can make this a nation of life, a nation where people can have weddings again, graduation, jobs, buy cars, get salaries, build houses, and do generally what people in a normal society do. We do have the plan, we do have the brain power, we are the thought leadership of Zimbabwean society. We have achieved a lot. We managed to bring in a new constitution, and what then follows is a new way of government. And that new way of government, we do believe that once we get power, we will be able to deliver a Zimbabwe that works for Zimbabweans.
Yeah. If the political parties in the court and mayor come together and choose Morgan Changa as the leader in the coalition, who is supporting or jump out of the coalition? Because when you back away from the MTC, you're misunderstanding.
Look, we have gone beyond individual misunderstandings. We all have our own faults. We are not forming a coalition of angels. We are forming a coalition of human beings. And we are perfect in our imperfections, as the common song goes. So we therefore do believe that if you are working together as human beings, they are bound to be criticism about one another. But that should not stop you from looking at the objective. That should not stop you from working together to achieve a better Zimbabwe for all Zimbabweans. We do believe that we have made our point. Our points have been taken, and we do believe we can come up with agreements that deal with human being imperfections. Remember, constitutions were put in place by people under the understanding that human beings are not perfect. And therefore, we will not jump out if one of us is chosen as the leader of the coalition. If Morgan Tsvangirai is chosen as the presidential candidate for the coalition, then be it. If Maimu Njuru is chosen as the leader for the coalition, then so be it. If Tendai Biti is chosen, if Nelson Chamisa is chosen, so be it. We need the coalition to work, and we cannot all run for the same post at the same time. And that is what history has taught us.
So we fully beg.
We will beg the person who will be selected as the coalition candidate.
But there is a problem of what Ricky. Whenever the opposition failed to win the election, they were alleged that it was for what Ricky. Which are the measures that have been put in place to tackle?
Yeah, it's called vote rigging, or in other words, vote manipulation. Rigging has got a very narrow construct. But voter manipulation is brought. Violence, manipulation of the system, working the opposition against each other, the delay in the release of results, releasing of wrong results, forcing people to vote in a particular way, voter slips, and so forth. We've put in a cocktail of measures. And the Grand Coalition is one of the measures to avoid voter manipulation. It's one of the measures to avoid voter manipulation, in the sense that if we are united at the opposition, we do not allow a situation where the ruling party can play with the percentages and say this one got so much and therefore no one got 50+1 percentage vote. So that is one of the monitoring of voter reforms that are contained in the code documents, that are contained in the NERA document, are part of the things that need to be reformed. What's happening in the state media needs to be reformed. Violence on the ground needs to be reformed. Use of state resources by the ruling party needs to stop, and so forth. Those are the things that were put in place to avoid a repeat of what has been happening before.
And don't you think joining the coalition will be able to show to the PDP supporters? Who joined the PDP hoping that Mr. Lute is going to be the president? Will bring change? Or what are you doing? Are you educating them so that they will accept the candidate?
Yes, look, we do not. The cause, let's remember that part of what we are struggling against is a dictatorship. So the first thing is to create a transitional phase from the dictatorship to a more democratic platform. So therefore, we need to have an arrow or a spear that removes the ZANU-PF from the dictatorship of ZANU-PF. And then after that, anyone can compete. People can sell their ideas on a fairer platform. There will be a democratic dispensation in the country, a new way of running politics. And therefore, all of us can go back to our positions, to our parties, to our various persuasions, or even become independent. But all that is not possible for as long as we are under ZANU-PF.
You mentioned the issue of the constitution. The government has taken long to align the constitution and the laws that they have been using, like the POSA laws. What do you think? What's your view on that?
Well, we know why they're doing that. ZANU-PF had to be dragged kicking and screaming to come up with a new constitution. Remember, their mantra had always been that they see nothing wrong with the Lancaster amended constitution. They were, in their mind, they were doing just fine. And therefore, now that they're the sole power, they are not willing to give up that power or to be able to implement reforms that, in many ways, deal with the reduction of power from ZANU-PF to the people.
So in the policy, do you trust those who take from ZANU-PF, who were chased from ZANU-PF, that's the one who does anything?
Politics is based on mistrust. Politics cannot be based on trust. It is not an energy. Even energy do not have trust. We put in rules and regulations. We declare our objectives at the beginning in order that we are clear what you intend to do. That's why we have manifestos, that's why we are having agreements. We need to learn that mistrust in politics is good. We are where we are because people tend to trust political leaders as if they are religious leaders. Our political leaders are not religious leaders. They are leaders of political party, human beings, with all their faults. And they can only be controlled by the straitjacket of constitution, vigilance, and agreements that you enter with them. And therefore, we will not enter into a debate as to whether we trust this person or that person. But we can trust the result that comes out from working together. Because if we follow a results-based union, the results will show whether what you said you are going to do at the beginning is what you have done at the end.
Can Zimbabweans expect to change, or is just alter of power from the current ruling party to...
No one can be worse than Robert Mugabe in this country. They have failed dramatically. They've changed the rural, they've changed the urban areas into rural areas. There are now people going to boroughs in the cities. There are no lights in the cities. Even the tower lights that the colonialists had put are no longer functioning. The streets have no names, the new ones that they've put. The old streets that were there, we are using memory, because they are no longer roads. But everyone remembers that there was a road here. They can't even take sewage from one house to throw it away. They can't take garbage. They can't even heal themselves in this country. Can't even run a hospital. They have to fly out every time. They can't even run an aeroplane that they use to fly out and get healed. So ZANU-PF is hopelessly incompetent. Robert Mugabe is hopelessly incompetent. And no one can be worse than what we are seeing. As they had a current, they even lost their own current. A whole country which could not even manage a current on its own. They adopt another country's current. They even mismanage that current. It's no longer there. So that is, they are beyond useless. It's unbearable love. Completely unworkable. Mota yakaiswa pachitina isingambobvi yakafamba. So, we will be better, far much better. And we have shown it during the inclusive government that as the opposition, we do have the brain trust to turn around things in a short period of time, which we did, and which we can do again in the shortest period of time.
And People are just saying ZANU-PF is trying to resuscitate the economy by roadblocks and fines. Do you think that will be possible?
Well, it won't be possible because Yaguja was saying that the police are getting cash, but they don't even know where it's being banked. No bank has recorded the cash deposits from the police. The money is disappearing. They can't even be honest enough to hand over money that they are stealing from the motorists. Where is it? Who is keeping a record? How much do they get per day? Where does it go? Who uses it? What is it used for? Surely all that information cannot be security information. It's money from the public, and the public need to know where the money is going and how it is being used and who benefits from it. Is it the ordinary policeman or just a few fat cats whose personal economy is grown? If at all that money improves any economy, it has probably improved the personal economy of some fat cats in the police.